you're considered, with respect to women's rights, the Thurgood Marshall of feminism. You are. Anybody who knows about the history of the legal battles believes that, but you have been very reticent with that comparison.
Yes, yes, it's not an apt comparison because whatever I did, oh, I should say we copied Thurgood Marshall's technique in that is making building blocks, not asking the court to take a giant step. So Thurgood Marshall would say to courts, separate but equal is not before the House today. These facilities are vastly unequal. Right. And won his cases that way until he was able to say, now we can see that enforced separation of the races can never be equal. So we took that measured approach, building step by step. We copied that from him. But the enormous difference is when Thurgood Marshall came to a southern town to defend someone, he didn't know if he'd be alive at the end of the day.
And you didn't face that?
Yes.
But you have called yourself, and others have, a ferocious feminist litigator.
A flaming feminist.
A flaming! And so when they say Notorious R.B.G., do you like that?
My clerks asked me, do you know where that comes from? I said, yes, I've heard of the Notorious B.I.G.
Yes, right, big.
And it seems altogether natural because we have one very important thing in common, Notorious B.I.G.
Would you?
And me. We were both born and bred in Brooklyn, New York.
All right. So you know something about the Notorious B.I.G.
Yes, he died young.